Hi and welcome to this video where I will show you how to set up an Azure Active Directory application in Microsoft Dynamics NAV. In this video you will see the steps required to configure the Power BI service and Azure Active Directory to be able to add Power BI reports to a user's role center. We'll get there through these steps. In the first step, we will go through the requirements to be able to start up the registration. In step two, I will explain how to register Dynamics NAV in Azure Active Directory. And in step three, we will run and execute the Azure Active Directory wizard. Let's get started with the first step, in which I will explain you what you need to be able to get started with embedded Power BI in Dynamics NAV. So to be able to get started, what we need is a Microsoft Dynamics NAV application, which is up and running and installed. And it needs to be using Azure Active Directory authentication, which means if you log on to the application, you need to do that using Azure Active Directory. What we also need is a Power BI account. You can create one here at powerbi.com. And last but not least, we also need an Azure Active Directory account, which you can create here on this portal. Let me demonstrate that. So when I log on to the application, you notice that I'm using Azure Active Directory. And in this case, I will log on as the user Jane Doe. I provide the passwords using my Azure Active Directory account, and I'm able to log in to the application. You notice that from within Dynamics NAV, because I'm logged on using Active Directory, I can have a look at the available applications here on the left top. They will open. Power BI is a part on there. When I select it, I log in to the Power BI service on powerbi.com. If you don't have that available, you can very easily go to the powerbi.com website and just create a free account, and you need to be able to log in. Next, as an administrator, I go to the Office 365 Administration Center on the portal.office.com. There I can select my Azure Active Directory in the admin centers. When you do that, it will open either using the old classic portal or the new renewed portal. You can perform the setup with both portals, although I would recommend to do it using the new portal. Now that we have our requirements set up, it's time to get started with the next step, in which we will register our Dynamics NAV application in Azure Active Directory. To do that, we need to start to log into our account on the Azure portal. Then you select More Services, Application Registrations or App Registrations, and then in the App Registrations blade, we select Add. Let me demonstrate that. Here in the Azure portal, you navigate at the bottom, you go to More Services. You can look for a service, or you can start by typing in the name. In this case, look for App Registrations. We select the App Registrations, which then opens the blade. This is what we actually call a blade. Here we can create a new one by clicking on the Add button. And what you then need to provide is some information about the application, name, web, API, and a sign-on URL. So in the Create blade, when you create your app, you need to provide a name, which you can choose, an application type, which must be Web App API, and the sign-on URL, which has the following format. It's basically the same URL than the one you use for the web clients, but then you need to add OAuth landing at the end. Once we create the application, the next thing is to select the application and open the Essentials and Settings blades on the right. And we need to do that to be able to add our required permissions. So let's see how that works. So when you create your application, it becomes available in the App Registrations. You can select it, and the Essentials Settings blade opens. And then on the right side, what we need to do is go to the Required Permissions. From within here, you select the Add button. A new blade opens. In there, you select an API. The next blade opens. Here you can look for a number of available APIs. And what you need to select in here is the Power BI permission. Once you select the Power BI service, you then go to Select Permissions. So as you notice here in the permissions for my Power BI service, I selected all permissions, but View Reports should be sufficient. So we created our app and also the required permissions. Next, select Done and then navigate back to the Settings Blade. Go to Keys from the Settings Blade and copy your key. Be careful, the key will only be visible once. Let me demonstrate. So from within the Settings Blade, you select Keys. A blade opens here to the right, in which it displays the key only once. So you need to go in there and copy your key. Be sure that you copy your key completely, because once you leave this blade, it will not be available anymore. In case you forget to copy it, or you don't know where it's stored, you will need to create a new key. So we copy that because we need that later. Once we have our key, then we go to Properties, and in Properties highlight the application ID and also copy that one. Let me demonstrate. So from within the settings, we select Properties. A new blade opens here on the right side, in which we can see the name of the application, the object ID, and the application ID. This application ID we need to copy and also store it, for example, in Notepad, because we need it in a few moments. So we have copied our key and application ID, and we are ready now to start with step 3, where we will run the Active Directory wizard. So in the application, you navigate to the Azure Active Directory wizard in Dynamics NAV. It opens, and in the window we need to enter the ID and the application ID which we copied before. Let me demonstrate. In the application, there are two ways to get started to launch the wizard. One way is to go to our role center and then select Power BI reports. The other way is to go to the assisted setup using the search functionality of the application. In the assisted setup, you select Setup Azure Active Directory, a wizard starts. In this wizard, you read the welcome screen, you select the Next button, and there in the application ID and in the key, you enter the information that you copied before, you select the Next button and then Finish, which will then finish up the connection with Power BI on Azure Active Directory. Let's summarize our steps. In the first step, I explained the requirements to be able to get started. In step 2, I demonstrated how to register Dynamics NAV in Azure Active Directory. And in step 3, we ran the Azure Active Directory wizard, which made the connection. In this video, we covered the following topics: how to set up an Azure Active Directory application and how to create and configure an Azure Active Directory application. For more information, please visit the following resources. Thanks for following this short video to explain how to set up an Azure Active Directory application in Microsoft Dynamics NAV. This video in the How Do I series for Dynamics NAV is brought to you by Microsoft and Platan. See you in the next one.